friend is the print artist. Ah,
look at her!
I'm just recognized everywhere I go.
Oh, wait, that's Susie Patoche. She does all the horse stuff, right?
Yes.
Horse
flowers,
I think.
And Deb, who does the lungs?
Yeah. And then Paul Richmond?
Oh, they know me.
It just keeps wanting to lean towards you, Denise. Look at it.
You know, lens is all a beauty.
Pretty color.
Susie, you're eating peanut butter, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
We're going to the Bay Area to see three different exhibitions. One's in Oakland with our friend Terese Garcia. One is in Richmond with a piece of my work through the California Society of Printmakers. And then the other one is the ICA.
That's what we're doing.
Just start like peeling off the layers and just do the I am so hot. Just kind of rework this whole hot flash thing.
Yeah.
It's my friend Susan. I remember she had a hot flash and she started like tearing everything off. She's like laying there. I was like, you are so sexy right now with your hot flash.
What was the first piece of art that you saw that hit you really hard?
I was with Rob and we went to the Vancouver Art Gallery and it was a show of Emily Carr, Frida Kahlo, and Georgia O'Keeffe. And it was looking at these women's lives as women coming up as painters in the, was it like the early 1900s?
Mm-hmm.
And it was about geography and relationship to place and how that showed up in their work. And it was stunning. And each of them, their artwork spoke to me in different ways. And it was just beautiful.
As a child, my uncle was in Japan. When he and his family came home, they brought a lot of prints. And one of my favorite prints that he gave to my mother was of some fantail goldfish. I was fascinated with fantail goldfish at the time. And so this print that was framed in a bamboo frame, seeing all the lines in it. And then as I got older, realizing it was a woodblock print. Mm-hmm. How hard would that be to make those fine lines up? I think that's probably why I'm fascinated with all the woodblock cutting and stuff.
When I was in college, there was a show at the Columbus Museum of Art, which is right next door to the college, and it was Kehinde Wiley. The painter who did Obama's portrait. But he came to town and traveled around, and he always works with local models. He just goes around and finds like guys on the street and has them come back and photographs them. And he based all their poses for that show on like classical Renaissance paintings that were in the museum's collection. So it was these paintings of just local black men being portrayed in ways that, you know, you'd never see black men painted, and they're huge and they're intricate, and I just was like completely fascinated with it. Tell us about your inspiring art moments.
The unfortunate thing is I can't remember the name of the artist because he was a fellow grad student with me in Chicago.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it was the first piece of art that I saw that was an installation piece that I finally got. Like I got what it was about, and it was just this random room off this side by the Art Institute down this hallway, and I knew there was something there by him, and I walked in and it was a white room. It was about 10 feet by 10 feet, and as soon as I walked in there I was like, what am I looking at? And then I looked up and I saw this fishing rod that was implanted in the wall, and it was coming up towards the ceiling, and it was bent down with a lot of tension in it, and I'm like, oh. And there was no string or no line, but I followed my eye down to where it would be, and the side corner of the wall sheetrock was curled up with a hook in it.
Mm-hmm.
And it was so interesting. And then I realized I was hearing very light breathing in the background, and then a heartbeat.
Oh,
a slow heartbeat. And I cried. It was about his grandfather who had just passed away, who was a fisherman. He used to take him fishing when he was a child. I think his name was Eric. I could be wrong. He was cute, though.
Here we are in San Jose.
It's sunny here.
But we're going to this place, ICA.
Once and for all, we are going to learn what the I stands for.
Oh, yeah. We don't know that yet.
Contemporary art. We know it's contemporary art. I love that they blink.
Uh-huh. Yeah, they're like alarmingly lifelike.
Look up here.
This one feels very Suzy to me.
Yeah.
Tracking.
Mm-hmm.
Target.
So it's from the different eyes, right?
That's right.
This is a true car bitch.
Yeah.
The fight to get to Denise's show.
Yes. Look at the crowd.
It's all heading to that one art storage bridge space.
Yep. You'd think that all the cars would like part ways so that the star of the show could get through.
You would think.
If only they knew.
I don't know about that. Oh, I am hot.
Yes, you are.
I'm burning up, as a matter of fact.
Smoking.
Do you want Madonna?
Yes. Yes, indeed,
we
do.
Need Madonna.
Oh, star.
Oh, fighting the traffic. To the show.
I wouldn't just do this for anyone.
That's not. I would hope not.
So here we go on our way into Denise's opening.
One piece.
The star has arrived.
So the show is supposed to be images or pieces that were a point of departure in your career.
Thank you.
it's like a little kid's lunchbox, as well as one of those hard cover books, hard paste books. My childhood drawings with my family. By the way, in case there's any questions, I'm playing with the ball. Oh wait, and I am. I am giving the talk. I'll set it back on like they had it.
So Susie, we're getting ready to go meet your favorite cousin.
Oh, my
now,
favorite
right?
cousin, Steven. I can hardly wait.
It's the favorite cousin. Introduce him, Susie.
This is my favorite cousin, Steven.
Likewise.
Steven!
He lives here in Berkeley.
Yes.
So I invited him to come with us.
Here's Berkeley, everyone. What's this thing on top?
Microphone.
Microphone.
The microphone.
Oh, microphone.
Captures every
everything
important word you say.
Every utterance. Any idea where to get in?
This is all. That says Jack London right there. We don't know what in the hell we're doing. Here we come, Terese. It's so exciting. It's so pretty out. You see her? Oh. You go first since you're the driver.
Oh, I'm the driver?
Yep.
In so many ways.
Yes.
Oh.
This is on. Terese.
Oh my god!
Hello!
Oh my god, you're so
Yes. Tell us about your work.
All right, so I'm an OGS member, and I've got this show right now at the Jack London Square Realty, and I'm an abstract non-linear artist, and I'm happy to see all you guys, and my work really is about the unknown and the non-linear. It's done in a mindful process. I'm not a Buddhist, but I have kind of like propensity towards meditation and mindfulness. This work is really not spontaneous, but observation and experimentation and taking huge risks.
Yes.
Not really knowing what the work is going to be, but just taking huge risks and believing in what I want to say as a visual artist. Some of the pieces are a breakaway from what I was doing with painting. It's using recycled refuse, and it's just process painting. It's just a lot about what Eva Hesse, she's one of my favorites, Agnes Martin, they were taking risks, and even George O'Keefe took risks.
Uh-huh.
But it's just really about staying true to who I am. They have mixed media. I've got paintings that are up here and then mixed media. And I'm committed until I die.
That's awesome.
To do work.
Good.
What made you decide to go to the recycled materials and use oil paint and do these constructs?
Well, my husband, I don't know why this is. I'm not sure, but I'm going to theorize right now because my art isn't theory. It's real time. It's, you know, art, as you know, you're a painter. It's real time. You're in front of your piece. But I'm going to theorize right now to that question and say it's not that it's what it is, but it's my husband went through that huge thing of almost dying and then rehabbing, and now he's long term in a nursing skill facility. And I think impermanence hit me in the face during 2016 to 2017 and now. And I don't know if that's why, but oddly enough and curiously enough, I started to just, I had all these bottles and I'd always wanted to do something. And maybe because of that experience, I thought, life is short. He almost died. He's changed so much and so have I. Let me use something that's also about impermanence and change, but make the recycle that would go away and get into something else into a visual art. I really don't know if that's why, but I noticed that at the same time I started to use these materials that don't cost any money. I didn't go to an art store. I went and got thread and old bottles that I was collecting for God knows why, and I thought, bring them in here and just do something different. So I think because I've gone through so much change in the last 2 years, I also wanted to reflect that in my art by using different mediums, but stay true to being abstract, non-linear, and impermanent, and observational, and so that could be why.
So what did you think of this glorious exhibition?
It was divine!
It was, wasn't it?
I don't have any words, I just like how I feel when I look at it.
Me too.
Divine, was that the word we had?
Yes.
Yeah, it was quite lovely.
She was lovely.
Yeah. She was on fire tonight.
So we are heading back now to Monterey. So
heading
This is time to say goodnight to everyone.
Good night, everyone.
Thanks for watching. If you like this video, go down and subscribe to my channel so you can hang out with all these awesome people more. Good night.